Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about the levels of measurement, and this becomes important as you look at data and get further into that. The nominal level is the weakest of all the categories. It consists of names, labels, or categories that really can't be organized in a meaningful way. If you categorize cities as safe, dangerous, or livable, or you listed people according to the degree program they were enrolled in, or their religious affiliation, even numbers on a jersey. So numbers on a jersey, you seem like, well, there's numbers, you can organize them by number, but there's no meaning to that in any way. Somebody with a jersey number 15 or 17 doesn't tell you anything better about one or the other. Similar with Social Security numbers, anything where you could replace the numbers with just different symbols, the numbers aren't important. It's just a way to identify something. So you might see something where you have to circle a smiley face or choose which animal you like the most. Those would all be nominal levels. Ordinal data is data that can be organized in some way, but the difference between the levels are meaningless or cannot be quantified. Likert scales, whenever you rate your professor or talk about how much you liked something, that's going to be a Likert where, yes, there's a 1 through 5, but it's not really that meaningful because my 4 might be your 3, somebody else's 5. Grades are ordinal. Pain levels from 1 to 10. In fact, when you're talking about ordinal level, it's the easiest to remember just to think it gives you order, but little else. One of the things you could do is have a scale with peppers, and what's the hotness scale, and you could choose, you know, from the smaller to the greatest or whatever. That's ordinal data because it does have an order, but it doesn't really have a significant memory meaning for us. The interval level is the next set of data, and it consists of values that can be ordered, and the distance between the values is meaningful. There's no true 0 point or fixed beginning. They do not have a true 0, even if one of the values carries the name 0. And you can't calculate meaningful ratios. Temperature. So you could be at 0 degrees, but there's also negative temperatures, right? So it's not a starting point at 0. Test scores such as ACT and SAT are interval level data. They don't have a true 0 point. Nobody can take one of those tests and get 0. Also for IQ or in IQ tests. Women dress sizes, you could have a 0 size dress, but 0 doesn't really have a meaning in that case, right? So it's a level, an interval, it's a data level that we use a lot, excuse me, but it doesn't have as much value as ratio level, which is the has an absolute 0. It consists of values that can be ordered, the distance between the values is meaningful, and is a true 0, and you can count meaningful ratios. Distance traveled, you could go nowhere, that's 0, there's a definite fixed beginning, or you could travel a distance. 5 miles compared to 10 miles, that the difference in between those are something that makes sense. The number of children that someone has, the height, any of those are ratio level data. And finally, the summary nominal is just categories only. Ordinal has order, but little else. Interval has differences, but no 0 point. And ratio has a difference and a natural 0 point. All right, thanks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next.